Hey everybody, back at you with another exciting video. And this is very exciting because guess who's behind the camera?
Hey y'all.
Nick is back filming. Isn't it great? So anyway, a lot of these videos that we do, a lot of them are based on some of the questions and the comments and the suggestions that I get from things. And somebody was recently talking to me, a friend of mine was talking to me about, that's a cool waterfall, ain't it? I don't want to fall in. Anyway, a friend of mine was recently talking about how he's building a shelter that's going to be insulated, okay? And not many people have much experience with that, okay? A lot of them have more experience with just a tent. And when the wind comes blowing hard and the snow comes down and it's just brutally cold, all you've got separating you is a thin piece of waterproof nylon, okay? Tents aren't insulated. Now, tents are breathable, and they have to be breathable because anybody that's ever closed himself up in a tarp shelter, they know that the condensation from your breath collects on the roof and drips down the walls, okay? So my insulated shelter kind of cures that, and I'll explain why. And another friend of mine was talking one time and said that I very rarely ever show a two-person shelter. So with this insulated shelter, I'm going to show a one-person version and then a two-person version, okay? So this is a pretty mild day today. Last week we had all rain with some snow, brutal cold wind. It was terrible. And today it's like the high 50. It's a nice day. It's a good day for filming. So me and Nick figured we'd get out and show y'all a little bit about it. So first off, let's look at the gear that we've brought for this. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is go over the gear, okay, because I don't really want to fool with it later, and I've got it all piled up right here. Okay, got everything I need right here. Now, for the first shelter, for the one-man shelter, if you want to have the wind and the snow and everything just blocked out, this is your baby. Ain't that right, Nick?
Oh yeah, you want to have that, definitely.
All right, so what it is, and I'm going to say something else real quick. Let's take a look right here real quick. What's right here is for the one-man shelter, okay? Now this is somewhere in the neighborhood of seven to eight pounds for everything that you need, okay? 7 to 8 pounds. Now, before I have some arguing about people talking about weight, this is for the two-man shelter. Everything in this compression sack and in this blanket, okay? This is combined 12 to 13 pounds. I think it's more like 12 pounds, okay? Now, before that is said, what this is tarps, ropes, and a camo moving blanket, okay? Real cheap stuff, you can buy it anywhere. Now, the military bivy system, I think it's called the military sleep system, or MSS. It's a four-part system. It's got like a two bags and a liner and a Gore-Tex cover, okay? That baby is anywhere, depending on new or used, it's anywhere from $100 to $300, depending on if you get the full system. And that system weighs 13 pounds, okay? Now that's great if you can afford it. It's a good system. This says that if you've got the right clothing, it'll go down to negative 50 degrees with all four layers. But that's 13 pounds for one bivy. This is 7 pounds for one person, and I can promise you this baby will keep you just as warm, okay? This over here weighs the same as the MSS, but it's for two people. And all you got to do is you can divide these up, and I'll show you how me and Nick divide it up. Nick, you love carrying this stuff in, don't you?
Oh, yeah.
I thought you did.
Hey, at least I get a place to sleep tonight.
That's right. You got a nice warm place to sleep. All right. I'm gonna go over this, and then I'm gonna lay this here, and we'll go set up the one person first, okay? Now what this is, you can vary the ingredients, but I have pretty much figured out what works for me, okay? I use an El Cheapo tarp, okay? What this tarp is it's a 7x9, okay? This is a camo moving blanket, okay? And I've added some eyelets to this thing, and I carry it rolled up with a Fast Tech webbing and buckle. Okay. No big deal. And then I carry my good old beloved rope, 100 feet of rope. Okay, the reason I like rope is because if you get into a mess or if you wind up on a TV show, a survival show on TV, you can always lower yourself down a cliff like they always seem to do. Nick, when's the last time we run into a cliff we had to lower down?
Not really ever.
Yeah, been a while, hadn't it? But anyway, that's on TV. But anyway, basically, you can make anything out of rope. Anything. A chair, a bed, a seat, a shelter, anything. With that said, you can knock a few pounds off because you can set the same system up with paracord if you want to. Or you can use what is called mini rope. This rope here is 3/8. Okay, 3/8 Rothco rope. It's my favorite. This is 3/16 rope. All right, sorry for that minor inconvenience, but we had to move. Nick, did you have any idea that water moccasins could be active in the winter?
No, I did not.
Evidently, when it hits 50 degrees, they can come alive and out of the water and after you.
Learn something new every day.
Oh, man. Now I'm rattled. Okay. Now, what I'm saying, I carry rope. Okay? I love rope. You can use it for lots of reasons. Okay? There's plenty of things you can do with it. Make a ladder, chair, seat, bed, shelter, whatever. But you can also use paracord or you can use mini rope. Okay? Now, the thing about the blankets here, there's a difference in the blankets, okay? I'm fixing to show you. Let's wrap this back up. Okay, one-man shelter. We're fixing to set it up right over there, okay? But while we're on the subject of gear, I'm going to pull everything out of here, and I'm going to show you. If you're with two people, I'll show you how you can divide this up, okay? Normally, you'll carry this in your backpacks, but I put all this in a stuff sack so I can keep up with it. Now, both of you will carry some kind of a blanket, but what Nick and I always carry, or you can carry a small piece of fabric. You'll understand more in a minute. But Nick and I both carry a poncho liner, okay? That's his, that's mine, okay? This is how the two people divide things up. One of you will carry the tarp, 10 by 12, okay? And then one of you will carry the rope, okay? That's how you divide that part up. And then one of you will carry a moving blanket, and the other will carry a moving blanket, okay? Now, you can have a normal plain Jane blanket for the first version, but for the second version, you need modified blankets, okay? So those are the two piles that you'll be carrying. Now, I want to show you something real quick right here. This blanket that has the white stitches is very extremely thick. This is a cheap blanket from Harbor Freight, okay? This blanket, this is a camo moving blanket too, but I bought this at Northern Tool. And if you'll see, it's got black stitches, okay? This is actually a lot smaller and not as padded. So there's a difference in the two if you want them. And I think this one's made by American Moving Blanket Company. And I don't know who this is made by, but anyway, I've added some webbing to them in different places, and you'll see after we've got it laid out on the ground what all I've added to it, okay? Now, I'm going to leave both of these laying here, and let me get some of this stuff off. And now what you're going to do is for the one-person shelter, what you need is one big tree and a little tree. Or if you have to, you can use two big trees, but for me, it works better. It works better with a little tree and a big tree, and I'll show you why. I'll explain why in a minute. And with the two-person shelter, you need two big trees, okay? Because that's just what it takes. And no, I have not got a haircut yet. Nick, have you been after me about getting a haircut?
All the time.
All the time. I'm going to get a haircut soon, I promise. To me, though, winter time is not the time to get a haircut. You know it? Anyway, all right, let's grab this and let's go find a tree. Here, what you need is you need one small tree and you need one reasonably big tree, okay? All right, and bigger than that would be nice, but we're in a hurry and I'm not going to use this one man filter tonight. Now, they need to be about 6 feet apart. 7 feet would be perfect, okay? But what you want to do, I can make it work regardless. What you want to do if you want to double check, you got your blanket and you got your rope. What you want to do is you want to take, say this is a 7 foot by 9 foot. You want to take your 7 foot side, stretch it out, put this up.
Just a little note.
Sure.
Huh? Sorry about the shadows and the how dark it is. Sun's setting and we got to get this shelter done.
Oh yeah, I know the shadows are terrible. Alright, what you want to do. Okay, see how the 7 foot side is very extremely close to almost touching? That's excellent. If anything, you want it to be about a foot more, okay? Hey look, airplane. We're rescued.
Yeah, another, it's a rescue team.
Another survival TV scenario. We're rescued! Alright, enough of that. Get that out of the way. Now, what you want to do is you want to take your rope, okay? And you want to, where's the end at? It's right here. Okay, you want to tie it off right here. And you want to tie it off about, I don't know. What you tie off here will be the top of your shelter, okay? I'd say between 2 to 3 feet, all right? So we're going to tie that off. I usually use what's called a cinch knot. That way you can just cinch it right up to the center line of the tree, okay? Now what you want to do is you want to come from here all the way down to the bottom to the base of this little tree and you want to wrap it around, okay? Give it a pull with this hand and a push with this hand. You have to sit on the ground and give it a pull. Okay, now wrap it around and then come up to the tree and then you want to go down a little bit lower than the top line, okay? And then you're going to wrap around. Now see, this is one thing here, if the tree is what you call hug sized, that's pretty good, okay? Give it a pull. Wait a minute. Let me just walk around the tree. Give it a pull. And then I'm going to walk all the way back around the tree. So you give it that extra loop right there and it gives it a little bit extra hold. And then you want to come down here. All the way to the bottom. Okay. Give that a pull. And then go around again. Now the next time, you want to come around the bottom of the tree and do the same thing. Go around the tree twice. This bottom can be a little loose. Ugh. All right. And then you wrap it around the bottom.
Sure had a weird animal.
I don't know. Did you hear a sound?
Hearing like an animal out there.
All I could hear was leaves rustling.
Maybe a caribou.
Now, if any of you saw my extreme weather shelter, if you're worried about branches falling, if you've got excessive rope, you can go from tree to tree up top and make your protective line to stop bouncing trees. Now, you want to take your tarp. Pull it under. All right, you're kind of getting the gist of it now. And then you take your blanket. What you want to do with your blanket now? I can't remember the size of these blankets, but they're all the same. What you want to do is take the narrow side and slide it under. Okay. And normally what I'll do is I'll take a little paracord, and I don't even bother with the end. You can tie it off if you want to. But what I'll do is I'll tie off the very first eyelet. Okay? Okay, you got the very first one tied off. And then you take the blanket. Now, like I say, any old blanket can do. Years ago, I just used a regular blanket. But I never showed it on video. Hold on. I never showed it on video because it just didn't look as cool as a camo blanket. Are you picking this up pretty good even with the sun hitting it?
Oh, yeah.
All right. Now, I'm going to go ahead and tie this off down here just so that it doesn't come apart on me. So I don't look like an idiot on film. That's happened before. Okay, now what you want to do is flip this over. Pull it up. You got to have a little bit of room in here to get in. Okay? Now you're tightening this off to next to nothing. And then take the blanket and you just throw the blanket under. You don't even have to tie it off. See, another reason for this, you've got that double layer of blanket underneath you, and since the bottom ropes was a little loose, they'll give a little and they'll cuff in the blanket. And you don't tie off the bottom of the blanket because it's going to kind of position itself as you get in. Alright. Next thing you do is you take the tarp. See how that is, and you pull the tarp over. Look at that, wind's picking up already.
Oh yeah. We're right, even down this little valley over here.
Yeah.
See up there?
The wind's gonna be coming straight at us and hitting it. Alright. Hey, I may leave this up. Put the excessive gear in it tonight in case it rains. All right, cut that off so you can bring it around here and you can get a view of what I'm gonna do on this other side. All right, what comes next is we've thrown the tarp over. So what you wanna do now is lift this part up. You see how I've got the blanket. You wanna lift this up and then pull this over. I'm reaching in, putting it up while pulling this over. Okay. And then you just shove what's excessive up under it. Look, 7x9, yes, that is what this is. I wasn't totally sure, but I was pretty sure it's 7x9.
In a way, it's kind of like you're folding your own cocoon.
In a way, it is. Now, what you can do is you can tie these eyelets off up at the tree if you want to. I usually do that. Another thing you can do is you can tie around it, or with the excessive rope, you can take the rope and just start wrapping under it. But do it loosely because you want everything to kind of give a little.
Nice and snug with the shelter.
Nice and snug. All right. Now, I'm just going to lay that there. Now I'm going to show you how to get into this thing. Another thing you can do is you can lay branches on it if you want to. Lay branches up on the top. But basically, the way this works, this is one of them things where I've just showed you how to do it. But you got to build it and sleep in it to understand how incredible this works. This is the ultimate wind blocker. You will not get cold in this. I don't care how hard the wind is blowing. And it's cheap. Cheap's up our alley, ain't it?
Oh, yeah.
All right, let's try to crawl into it. Okay, now is the fun part where I crawl in. As you can see, I've got a blanket, and these ropes right here are kind of supporting the sides, keeping it off the ground a little bit. The blanket's wrapped around, okay? You got it on these. It gives you kind of a little roof by the way these are arranged. And this is wrapped around, and if you want to, you can tie up these ends with paracord, okay?
Oh, and another note, that little gap right there.
Yeah.
If you want a little more protection, all you have to do is you've got, obviously you got a whole tree here to deal with, so you can tie up another tarp around here for a little extra rain protection.
Yeah, you can. All right, let me, I'm going to take this machete off, because sure enough, it will get in the way and make me look like an even bigger idiot. And how do we feel about looking like idiots, Nick?
We're used to it.
All right, let's see. As a matter of fact, if you was in bear territory or wherever, you could, if you want to, you can hang your machete from up here. And you can have it to where you can get at it at night. Right there, where you can get at it. Now, take my boots off. Leave them by the tree. You put them up here by your head so that you can pull them in when you get ready to get in. Now, you stand up and you just crawl in backwards on all fours. Let's see. Now this is generally how I will do it, and I can pull myself all the way in, okay? And what I do is I take my boots, and I put my boots on the outside of the blanket, okay? One on each side. Then you take your jacket . See, I'm crawled all the way down inside here. Now you can take your jacket as an extra wind blocker, unless you want to use it as a pillow. And you drape it over the ropes. Wait a minute, that didn't work right. Hold on.
A note, in some circumstances, you may need a large jacket.
Never mind. You can take the sleeves. You tie a sleeve off. Okay. And then you tie the other sleeve off. I hope y'all can hear me. And then once you crawl inside, you can pull this towards you and shove it up on here. Pull the sleeves to you and lift it up.
Also, as you can see, it's got a nice little arc if you could tie it off in the bottom on this lower rope right here. It can act like a small pillow to elevate your head during the night.
Maybe.
Look, guys, it's a butterfly emerging from its cocoon.
Nice and cozy. Now, just remember, the smaller it is, the warmer it'll be. Ready to set up the two-man shelter, Nick?
Oh yeah, I'm ready to take a nap.
I am too, this has wore me out. All right, let's go find a spot for the two-man to set it up. Pretty dang good. We got two trees right here, and they're about probably 10 feet apart, probably. I think that'll work. We'll go with this, okay? Now, another thing we want to do is, if you'll see here, this little piece hanging off right here is dead, which is fine, because we're going to need a small piece for the design of this shelter. This shelter uses the same, is similar, the way the rope is, where you have the three at the top, one higher than the other two, but you don't have any rope at the bottom. And that's where these little sticks here are going to come in handy.
A little debris coming here.
Yeah, I noticed that.
This tree's really dead.
I know, the bottom's not. Alright. Now, I got that. I'm gonna set that to the side. Okay, the first step that you wanna do. And we've already cleared out some of the leaves and the sticks and things here. Put that back up. Wouldn't want to cut our little fingers. All right. Let's see. I see a couple more sticks here. Let's clear out. Oh. Alright, what we want to do is dig out the tarp first. Now this uses a, I believe it's a 10 by 12 tarp. If I remember right, got a rope, got two poncho liners. Or like I say, once you set this shelter up, the poncho liners are for covering up the ends. And once you've set the shelter up, you may want to just cut a triangle of fabric instead of carrying that. But we usually carry them anyway. All right, we have our rope, and you want to go. Let's start out with this. About, maybe 3 feet high. 2 to 3 feet, about like the other one. All right, pull that thing down. Right in the center line of the tree. Come down here. You're going to wrap around. Now this rope, this time, comes out on this side of the tree. So what you want to do is pass the rope over and go back around the tree. Because what you're doing then is you're pulling it to the center line of the tree. Okay. Now what you want to do, we'll go down a little bit lower, right about here, right there. You want to be a little bit lower by about a full hand's width from the top rope. Okay. Come down here. And you want one end just a little higher than the other. That way, in case any rain hits, the rain will fall off. And this will work out good here because there's a low spot right here where the rain will go in and go down and go over to the creek. Alright. Go around once, about a full hand width. Okay, and then come out about a full hand width. Up a little, right there. You want to make the two bottom ropes as level as possible. I might have this a little high, but I hope not.
It's pretty consistent.
Right. Had something in the way. Alright. Tie that off. Alright. Now we're good to go. Next thing we want to do. Okay, got one ridge line, and got two lines off to the side. I know people that's watched my videos, you've seen me do that 1,000 times. Okay, what you want to do now, take your tarp, and you want, the short end goes between the trees, and the long end goes this away. What do you call that? Perpendicular, parallel, what do you call that?
Sure, it might be perpendicular.
I think it is. Parallel would be this way. Perpendicular is this way. Alright. I gotta find the line in. I think that's the line. Just like that. Alright. Let me get this out of the way. Alright, now we'll adjust that around later. And I think I'm going to go ahead. I'm actually going to take my boots off for this one. Because I think you can film it off in that shot. Now remember I said one of these, the one with the white threads that came from Harbor Freight, is more padded. That is the one that I will use for the bottom. Okay. This is just a little harness I made out of webbing and Fastex buckles that I use for stuff like that. Alright. Now what I have sewn on the bottom, I could try to lay it out and show it off to you, but what it is, if you set up a shelter like this and set up a blanket like this, you'll have to do the webbing this way. Unless you want to do the eyelets. But what you do is on one side, you have these eyelets going across, okay, right here. Now it's been since last winter that I've used this. It may take me a minute to figure it out. And then in the middle of the blanket, there's another row of these. Can you see how there's rows? Nick, can you see how there's a row going straight down here?
Yeah.
Down here, they're in the middle, and then they're over there. Okay. Same thing with over here. There's a row over here. Okay, you got three rows of them. Alright, makes sense? So what you want to do is you want to lay that blanket down. Like that. You you want to put it to where those two rows right there are directly under here. If you have to, zoom in on these. We didn't cut that down very good. Hold on. That's not good. Alright, hold on. This ain't good. Anytime, that's another good reason for walking around while you're barefooted. If you feel any little nubbies that are sticking up, then get rid of them or they'll poke a hole in your tarp. Okay? Alright, put that down. Not to mention it isn't any fun to roll over in the middle of the night. Alright, let's get the other blanket. Alright, now on the other blanket, another fast Texas buckle. I like to put all this stuff back in the bag, that way I won't lose it. On this is one of those thinner ones. Now on this one, I have actual webbing sewn with a loop. Now this takes a while to sew all these on. I got loops all the way down. Okay. Now I got loops there, and I got loops on the other end. Okay. Now, the way this thing works, let's see. Okay, wait, this is for a different setup. See how there's a row of the little loops here, and a row in the middle, and a row in the middle? What this is for, sorry, that's for a different setup. You want to double it up. Okay. Now, what I'm going to do here, is you can take this part, when I throw this blanket over, you tie it off to here and tie it off to here. That is if you want double padding, okay? If you didn't bring a blanket with you, you want to pull this over, and you want to sew, you want to tie off to the one underneath it, okay? So what I'm going to do, here, cut the camera off and bring it around to the back side, and I want you to see what I'm going to do here on the back side. And I'm going to throw it over the ridge line. Just like that. Okay. Now, if you see down here what I'm going to do, you kind of get the idea that if you take this and you tie this off to here, okay, and then you tie this off to this other loop over here, which I'm going to go ahead and do. Let's see. Alright. If I tie this off to this top, then you're going to crawl in and you're going to have two layers of pad. Okay? Now, two people go in there side by side. Something else that you can do, which I think I'll do, is I'm going to fold this under, and then you lift this up and you can tie this off under here. So that when you crawl in, you have the option of two pads, or you can pull it back, and you can have a blanket, and you can crawl under here. Okay? Makes sense? That's behind the idea of the three things. Look, I still got the tag on it. Camouflage utility blanket. All right. Hey, how do you want this? You don't want a blanket tonight. You want both layers?
Yeah.
Well, let's just do that then. If you want to, you can zoom in on this.
Yeah, I have. We can see the, earlier we could see the grommets.
Okay.
Very nicely there.
Alright, tie that off.
Tie it off.
And see, I've got one to where you don't need to bring any extra paracord with this setup because it's got the webbing on it already. Now these webbing, the webbing here with the eyelets, that's for another setup on here. You could just have straight webbing. Because I've got to where I use these blankets constantly. I use them for everything. I love using them. They're great for shelter. Now let's ease around on it. As you'll see, real quick before you go around to the other side, this is just falling straight down. That's where the sticks come in handy, and I'll show you about them in just a minute. Let's ease back around on this other side here. My other side here, and you can see where I've got the blanket under there, maybe. And I'm just pulling it over. I'm stretching it and tying it off. Started doing this, I used eyelets on the blanket, and but the problem with that is when you use eyelets, you got to carry a bunch of paracord. I know a lot of people, they carry a pocket full of paracord, and I used to carry a pocket full of paracord, but you know, it's, I figured out, you know, these blankets are going to serve no other purpose other than camping and shelter craft. So you know, why not use them for this? So that's the reason I got them rigged up like this.
What's a little nifty about this shelter is, in addition to having it held up by the trees here, tying off the top, ceiling of the shelter, tying that off to the base, that pad that you're laying on, basically makes this windproof so it doesn't blow away in any storm.
Oh yeah, no doubt. Alright, I'm going to throw these in there. Put one at each end. Now I put my boots back on. And I will wrap up the tarp now. Wonder how long this video is going to be.
Oh, it doesn't matter. We have all our
hey, everybody wanted a long video, so they're getting a long video. Alright, well, what we're going to do now, if I got me some paracord in my pocket, we're going to tie up the tarp now. Yeah, I got some. Alright, we're going to bring that up and tie it off. Tie it to the very top. Okay. Then you leave this excessive part here dangling because you may need it. Let's see if I got another one here. And you want to bring the tarp a little bit past the blanket, especially on that end. Because on the higher end, where the lower end is, the lower end is where you want more tarp sticking out away from the blanket. This the most fun you ever had, Nick?
Oh, it's enthralling.
Enthralling?
Yeah.
I've never heard that term before.
It's fancy vocab there.
It is, ain't it? Alright, now, let's take the rest of the tarp here. Roll it over. Alright. Somewhere along the line, okay, you got it on that view?
Yeah.
All right, ease around on this side, and I'll show you how to tie off that part of it.
There'd be a vine we missed here.
Yeah, I can't believe that. There's a vine right here where we got to get in and out. I don't know how I missed that. I hate them vines. All right, what we're going to do now is protect our little fingers. Right? Alright, now if you're like me and you got a bunch of eyelets or added eyelets, what you want to do is you want to figure out a place to take this extra paracord here. And even if they don't line up, what you want to do is you want to take this excessive paracord and you want to run it through just like that. And then run it through here. Okay, and then run it back through the top. See, just because the eyelets don't line up, it doesn't mean that you got to bunch the tarp up right here. So, run this through. Leave a little bit of a loop. And tighten it up. Okay? So now you've got this end tightened up. And as you can see, the blanket is about 2 feet in. So what this part is here is this is going to be the little part where you're going to put your boots and stuff as you crawl deeper inside. That's going to be a doozy to film. Now, let's tie up this other end. There we go, we're good to go with that. Now, if you're concerned about this part here blowing away or lifting up, you can just lay branches on it. You can lay tons of branches on it like that right there. Or you can tie this off with paracord and stake it down to the ground. Okay. Now, the next part of it, the next part's gonna be hard to film because it's down inside it. But what you wanna do is take a real small stick so that you can get a measurement. This may work. Let's see. I think your best bet is gonna be, I don't know, maybe this thing. Yeah. All right, what you wanna do is you wanna measure with the tarp spread out to the top, okay? Which is gonna be about right there. I'm going to use a saw for this instead of hacking on it. What we'll do right here, saw it a little bit high. Alright. What you want to do is you want to shove that down in there. Can you see it from there good, Nick?
Yes.
Okay. You want two of them. You want that one that length. You really want two of them. The same length may work over here. Now it's gonna be a little bit shorter. Yeah, so what you want to do, did you see how I did that?
Yes.
I put that length on there and it's about a thumb's width high. This other end should be about a thumb width high. So what you want to do is you take your two fingers and lay it against it and cut right on the top. That don't make no sense, but that's what you got to remember. You want one length on one side, two on the other side, then cut off the excesses. Okay, once you've done that, you're going to have the excessive of what you want. Now, what you want to do is that thumb length, you want to cut halfway. Let's see. Okay. See how I've got the top right here? Stick this back in here. Oh, I didn't have it all the way. All right. Now, you see how I've sawed this halfway right through here? What you want to do now is you want to take and you want to notch that part out so that it's just like that. Because it's going to set just like that. So what you want to do now is you want to round off the top so that it won't poke into your tarp. This will make more sense when we put it on down there. But this is how you spread it out. Okay. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to grab that other stick. Alright, with these over here wide and look at it, if I can see what we're doing. I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to cut this off flat, like this. Okay. I'm gonna take this stick, lay it up there. Hopefully this will work out right. You may understand in a minute, and then again you may just have to understand whenever you're doing it. Take this, put that there. Saw it off. Alright. You got this piece, and what you want to do is you want to saw it halfway. You want to saw it off halfway, about a finger's width, because what that's going to do is that little notch is going to set up against the rope. May sound confusing, may sound like a lot of work, but it's all a part of bushcraft. You don't want to do this, bring a tent. Ain't that right? You want to lift that up. Alright, you got it halfway. Then you want to trim all around so that you don't poke a hole in your blanket or your tarp. Okay. No reason to chop down any live trees, because this is good enough. Alright. Now, let's ease the camera down here and get a closer view so that we can kind of see what we're doing. The way this thing works is, you're going to come, see how that's held up against the rope? The idea behind this thing is you're going to be on the outside of this rope. Okay, that's what's going to help support it. You put it on the very end, you're on the outside of the rope. Wait a minute, that ain't working. You want to be... This ain't working. This is supposed to be on this side, because that's how you even up the tarp. You got to scoot over the bottom of it. That's why it wasn't working. Alright. Now you can't tell at all, because this is in the way, because it's tied off. But if I'm going to show you on this side here, this is what it's going to look like. This is going to hold up. Okay. Sometimes you can have these on this side of the rope and going like this. Or you can have it on the inside of the rope and doing this. Okay. But you can't see either one. What I'm going to try to do is I'm going to try to put this on this side of the rope. And then I'm going to try to shove it in here. Wait a minute. Lifted it. See, it came off of it. This ain't good right here. This end is broken off. That'll poke a hole in a tarp right there. That right there will poke a hole in a tarp quick. I'm going to round all that off. I'm going to round off the other end. See, I'm trying to remember, on one end where the blanket is, you have to put it on the inside of the rope, and then on the other end of the blanket, where there's no blanket, just a tarp, you got to put it on the opposite side of the rope. So let's put this in here. And put this in here. Alright. Let me see if I can move it on this side. There it is. Put it on this side and press it up against it. You may have to come over here. you may have to come over here on this other side to get a better view of it. All right, now the idea behind this thing is you can't see it in here. This is very hard to film, but the idea behind this is where that notch is, when you put that notch right there like that and set it on that rope, it puts pressure on this. Okay? And that way what it does is it keeps the tarp spread out. Okay? Does that make sense? So what I'm going to do, you can't film it good inside there, but we'll try to get an inside shot, is where that notch is, it's got to go up against the rope See, as you can see, that rope's holding the pressure out. You push it in there, and that's what holds it out. Okay? Does that make sense?
Totally.
All right. And then I got this other side done right here. It's under pressure, and that's part of that idea behind that rope right there. Okay? So let's get the other end, and I'll show you where the blanket comes in on the other end. All right, I think I got these others here about ready to go. Cutting this off. This is fun, ain't it, Nick?
Oh, yeah.
All right, you want to round off every bit of that. And round off these edges. Just like that. All right. Now, I'm going to try to do this to where you can see it when my head won't be in the way.
Your head's in the way.
Is it?
Not really.
All right, now see how that right there is putting pressure on it? What you want to do, I think I may have this in too long. No, I don't. I got it just right. All right. Now, the way you do this in, like I say, this is the part I was talking about you making some little triangles of fabric. What I do is I take the poncho liner, and what you want to do is you want to slide this in. Actually, you put this part in first. Hey, that'll work. So you can see what I'm doing. Put that part in, and then spread this out. And then you want this inside the blanket. Can you see that, Nick, or is my head in the way?
I can see it.
Okay, now what you want to do next is you want to take this blanket, poncho liner, and you want to pull it around. Cram it up on top like that. And then pull it all the way around and put it in. Pull some over. Then cram that in. Now, then pull the tarp back over. That, let me get out of the way. Can you see that pretty good, Nick?
Yeah.
That is how you enclose the end of it. Okay? If you want to, you can pull this tarp on out further. Alright? Now what we're going to do, you got that enclosed in, and there's a little bit of a gap of it. So what we're going to do is we're going to crawl inside it. Ain't that going to be fun?
Oh, yeah.
All right, now I'm going to have to hold an LED light in here because we absolutely positively cannot show the inside of it. But now the way these sticks are on the sides, right here where this blanket is, you put more sticks and it'll spread it out like that. Okay? We're trying to wrap up this video here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get Nick to crawl in while I'm holding this light. All right, crawl in head first, Nick. And I'm gonna hold this light. Look, right there I can see. All right, crawl in head first.
Guys, I wouldn't recommend keeping your knife on when you go in.
Crawl on in. I'm trying to keep the camera on you.
Hey, try to knock it over.
Nah, okay, you don't. Alright, let me know when you're all the way at the end.
Alright, I'm up here.
Alright, now y'all roll over on your side.
See me?
Yeah, I see you. Alright, now take your hands and kind of spread the blanket out a little bit so that you can show them that there's room for me.
I just lay over here.
And see? And I'll just lay right over there. Now right where Nick is holding that blanket up, that is where the sticks will be that will help support it out a little ways. Okay, I hope this is showing up. So anyway, all right, well, that's basically it. We're about out of time, we're about out of battery, we're almost out of daylight, we're getting there. I hope you had fun. Nick, anything you want to add?
It's cozy.
All right, you gonna be warm tonight?
Oh yeah.
All right, you got any life's advice?
Stay safe, kids. Don't do drugs.
I said stay safe and don't do drugs. All right, we'll see you in the next one.
See ya.
Hey, one thing I forgot to mention in that video, because I got in such a hurry trying to think of all these other things. What I was going to say is the deal about earlier when I was talking about a tent being waterproof and it's got a vent in it and it vents. And if you have a completely enclosed tarp and you breathe in there, your breath, the condensation comes up. Anybody that's ever had an enclosed tarp shelter knows. When you have an enclosed tarp shelter, your breath will catch on the roof as condensate and drip down the walls and land and get you wet. Okay, everybody knows that. Now, the beauty behind this is not only does that blanket insulate you from the wind and the cold, but as you're breathing over the night, even two people, when you're cooped up in there, because you have that cloth overhead, it actually absorbs the moisture from your breath. And something else I say, Nick and I, we're bushcrafter camper type people. We're not really what you call survivalists. But if you ever did have to use this in a survival type situation, believe it or not, this is one way that you could actually recapture some of the water dispelled from your body. If you had some kind of a cotton garment, cotton t-shirt, or even if you had a towel, you could drape it on those ropes above your head, sleep in there, breathe at night, and then you can actually squeeze a little bit of the water back out of it in the morning. So, just food for thought. It's a thought I had that I wanted to mention, but I completely forgot about it, and it hit me, you know, just a little while ago. So I whipped out the old camera and got what little bit of battery left to say that. But anyway, yes, having cloth overhead absorbs the condensate, and I hope that helps out that friend of mine that's building an insulated shelter. That little tidbit of information may come in handy if you're completely enclosed. So, hope you had fun, and I will see you in the next one.